How to render 3D for 2D overpaint. Countless 2D artists use Blender for their 2D artworks. And it's straightforward. You place your objects, lights, camera and... But that's where it's getting interesting. By all means, you can just press render, get your picture and be done with it. But what if you need some extra control? Each object separated? Maybe for a hidden object game? I will tell you my approach to such a task. So, you've got your objects, lights and camera. Then, in render properties, choose the renderer you want to use. I will go with cycles. And don't forget to play with the settings. Also, very important to set the transparent checkbox on in the film section. Then, go to the output properties and choose your output folder. You can also change the file format or the size of your image here. And now you can go to render and press render image to render your image or render animation for animation. And that's it if you want it simple. But we want some complexity. First of all, as we will be doing a lot of rendering, let's set up automatic render export. Switch your workspace to the composing and check the use nodes checkbox. By the way, now we can see and choose which render passes we want to save. Right now we are getting only a composed image. But we can change that. Go to the view layer properties and choose the passes you need. For example, I want color, which will appear in the main node. Next, we will need an output node. Press Shift plus A, then output and finally file output. Click on it and let's open its properties. You can also change your output folder here, by the way. Here we can add outputs and change their names. I will add only one for my color. And then simply connect all of them. And that's it! Let's go back to the layout and start rendering already. There are only three objects in my scene, but oftentimes there are many more. And Blender collections will be a huge help to us. I created several collections. Here is my camera and light. And objects yet to render, done and rendering. If you click on this thingy, you will find restriction toggles in there. We will need to turn on selectable, disable in renders and indirect only. Then collection done will be disabled in render and viewport. Objects yet to render will be indirect only. And let's make your camera and lights unselectable. And now the fun part. We will work our way from the front object to the back one in 3 steps each. Step 1. Select the frontmost object and move it to the rendering collection by pressing M hotkey. Now you can see that even though we are not rendering other objects, we still get reflexes from them. And that's exactly what we want. Let's render this one. Go to the render drop-down menu and press render image. Let's see what we got and rename it. Step 2. We need shadows, but only from this object and not from the others. Turn off indirect only and hide the rendering collection just for now. Press A to select everything. Now in object properties, find the visibility tab and turn on shadow catcher. Then press the right mouse button and choose copy to select it. As you can see, every object except the rendering one is catching shadows now. And to hide the rendering object itself, use the indirect only. Once again, press render image and don't forget to rename your new render. Or it will be rewritten the next time you press render. And now step 3. Press A to select everything and turn off shadow catcher. Don't forget to click the right mouse button and choose copy to select it. Okay, now we are done with this object. Let's drag it to the done collection. All that remains is to repeat these steps with each next object. Yeah, it could take some time if you have a lot of objects, but it's not hard at all when you understand the process. I rendered the entire scene, and this is how it looks in Windows Explorer and in Photoshop. Now you can go on, overpaint every object and still be able to turn them on or off as needed. This method saved me a lot of headache when I faced such a task at my work.